Welcome. This is video number 204, simple linear regression with OLS estimation, and this video is meant for the beginner. Let me start with some terminology. In the simple linear regression model, where yi is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 xi plus ui, we typically refer to y as the dependent variable. It is also known as the left hand side variable or explained variable, or we can call it regressant. Similarly, in simple regression of y and x, we refer to x as the independent variable. It is also known as the right hand side variable or explanatory variable or regressor or covariate or control variable. A simple assumption: the error term in the population is assumed to be equal to 0, that is, expected value of u is equal to 0. This is not a very restrictive assumption, because we can always use beta naught to normalize expected value of u to 0. We need to make a crucial assumption about how x and u are related. We may want it to be the case that knowing something about x does not give us any information about u, so that they are completely unrelated. That is, expected value of u given x is equal to expected value of u is equal to 0, and it implies that expected value of y given x is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x. Expected value of y given x is a linear function of x, where for any x the distribution of y is centered about expected value of y given x. You may see that in this graph. Basic idea of regression is to estimate the population parameters from a sample, and the population parameters are beta naught and beta 1 in this example. Let xi, yi be the ordered pair, where I varies from 1 to n, and it denotes a random variable, a random sample of size n from the population. For each observation in this sample, it will be the case that yi is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 xi plus ui, and here in this figure you see population regression line, sample data points and the associated error terms. Derivation of OLS estimates. To derive the ordinary least square estimates, we need to realize that our main assumption of expected value of u given x is equal to 0, it also implies that covariance between x and u is equal to 0. Why this is so? Remember, from the basic probability that covariance of xy is equal to expected value of xy minus expected value of x times expected value of yi. We can write our two restrictions just in terms of xy, beta naught and beta 1, since u is equal to y minus beta naught plus beta 1 x. Expected value of y minus beta naught minus beta 1 x is equal to 0. Similarly, expected value of x into y minus beta naught minus beta 1 x is equal to 0. These are called moment restrictions. The method of moments approach to estimation implies imposing the population moment restrictions on the sample moments. What does this mean? Remember that for expected value of x, the mean of a population distribution, a sample estimator of expected value of x is simply the arithmetic mean of the sample. And we may choose values of parameters that will ensure that the sample versions of our moment restrictions are true. The sample versions are as follows: reciprocal of n times summation yi minus beta naught hat minus beta 1 hat xi is equal to 0, and reciprocal of n times summation xi into yi minus beta naught hat minus beta 1 xi is equal to 0. Given the definition of a sample mean and properties of summation, we can rewrite the first condition as follows: y bar is equal to beta naught hat plus beta 1 hat x bar, or beta naught hat is equal to y bar minus beta 1 hat x bar. Summation xi yi minus into y bar minus beta 1 hat x bar minus beta 1 hat xi is equal to 0, and summation xi yi minus y bar is equal to beta 1, summation I varies from 1 to n xi into xi minus x bar, and finally summation xi minus x bar into yi minus y bar is equal to beta naught summation xi minus x bar square. Rearranging this, beta 1 hat is equal to summation xi minus y x bar into yi minus y bar divided by summation xi minus y bar whole square, provided that summation xi minus x bar square is greater than 0. The slope estimate is the sample covariance between x and y divided by the sample variance of x. That is why we can say that beta 1 hat is equal to summation xi minus x bar into yi minus y bar divided by summation xi minus x bar square. If x and y are positively correlated, the slope will be positive. If x and y are inversely related, the slope will be negative. Only need x to vary in our sample. OLS is fitting a line through the sample points such that the sum of squared residual is as small as possible. Hence, the term least squares is used, and we call this method ordinary least squares method. The residual u hat is an estimate of the error term u, and is the difference between the fitted line, that is sample regression function, and the sample point. Sample regression line, sample data points, and the associated estimated errors are displayed in this figure. You can see the sample regression line, and then there is the estimated equation y hat minus beta naught hat plus beta 1 hat x, and there are the sample data points and associated estimated errors. You see u1 hat, u2 hat, u3 hat, and u4 hat. Vertically we measure y values, and horizontally we measure x values. Given that the intuitive idea of fitting a line, we can set up a formal minimization problem in this way. That is, we want to choose our parameters such that we minimize the following. That is, the sum of squared residuals, expected value, the summation ui hat square, and that is equal to summation yi minus beta naught hat plus beta 1 hat xi whole square. We want to minimize this. If one uses calculus to solve minimization problem for the two parameters, we obtain the following first order conditions, which are the same as we obtained before multiplied by n. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a very simple lecture about the simple linear regression model. You saw the various equation, the derivation of OLS estimator, its description and interpretation. I hope it has cleared your concept. If you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, kindly do subscribe to the channel, and do not forget to click on the bell icon so that you can get timely information about other videos that I'll upload for you. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in another video.